And welcome once again to Tales with the Storyweaver. Today's story comes to us from Ireland, oh, a place of many, many tales to be sure, a place where I could go and I could learn stories every day for the rest of my life, and I would just barely touch the edge of the stories there. The story I'm going to share with you today is called The Peddlar of Ballaghaderreen. Now, a peddler, we don't have them much anymore. They used to go door to door and village to village with a giant pack stuffed full of things that people would need. And they often were very gifted at mending things like pots and pans and dolls and toys. This story is found in a collection called The Way of the Storyteller by Ruth Sawyer, available at your public library. The Peddlar of Ballaghaderreen. There once was a peddler who lived in the little village of Ballaghaderreen in beautiful Ireland. And he was a good peddler. He always sold most of his goods. However, he had a habit of giving away almost as much as he sold. And so it was, he never had a great deal of money. And the peddler lived just outside of Ballaghaderreen in a very small, simple cottage. But behind this cottage was a tree, a great, huge oak tree, so big it could be seen from miles away. And as soon as someone saw that tree, they knew they were close to Ballaghaderreen. Well, the peddler one night, he went to bed as usual, and he had a dream while he was sleeping, and he dreamed that Saint Patrick himself, the patron saint of Ireland, came to him in his dream and told him, "Peddler, you are to go to Dublin, and there on a bridge over the River Liffey, you will find your fortune." Well, the next morning, the peddler woke up and thought, "Oh, I shouldn't have stayed so late at Paddy's or had that third pint." And he shook it off and he went about his business, selling goods in the villages close to Ballaghaderreen. And that night, when he went to sleep, there was St. Patrick again, in his dreams, telling him that he must go to the city of Dublin. And there, over the River Liffey, there is a bridge. And he must go to that bridge and stand on it, and his fortune would find him. When the peddler woke up, "Oh, goodness! Something must be wrong with the beer at Paddy's. Aye, I've got to quit drinking." And he went about his business for the day. But when he went to sleep that third night, and there again was St. Patrick with that very same dream. When the peddler woke up the next morning, he said, "Aye, there's nothing for it. I must go to Dublin." And so it was that he put all he had in his pack, for it would be a long way to Dublin, and he would have to sell his goods in order to have food and perhaps a place to sleep on the way. The peddler made his way to Dublin, selling as he went. And when he finally reached that great city, there was nothing left in his pack, nothing left in his pockets. But that did not dissuade the peddler. He found the River Liffey, and there was a great bridge over that river. And he went up and he stood on that bridge. And he waited for his fortune to come to him. Oh, there were many people passing back and forth over that bridge all day long, and the peddler would look at each one and smile in hopes that that was one who had his fortune. People would not even look him in the eye. None would return his greetings. At the end of that first day, the peddler, who had no money and no food, he simply went under that bridge and slept. And the second day, he got up and he went up on the bridge again, and he had himself prepared with his biggest smile. And as everyone passed, he'd look at them in the eyes, and they would look down. He would smile at them, and they would frown. By the end of the second day, no fortune had come to the peddler, and so once again, he slept under the bridge that night. The third day, the peddler went up, determined that this would be the day his fortune would come to him on that bridge over the River Liffey in the city of Dublin. But again, just as the 2 days before, no one brought his fortune to him. And by the end of that third day, oh, the peddler was so discouraged. And he left the bridge, He was going to go back to Ballaghaderreen. He didn't know what he would eat on the way or where he would sleep, but somehow or another, he would make his way home and he would start again. Now, those 3 days passed. The peddler had had an audience, unbeknownst to him. A publican, the man that owned the pub, there at the foot of the bridge over the River Liffey, had been watching this strange man standing on the bridge, trying to smile at everyone and speaking to everyone for 3 days. So when the peddler left the bridge, the publican said to him, "Peddler, peddler, tell me, why is it that you were standing on that bridge these 3 days past?" "Oh, it's a long story," said the peddler. "My throat is dry and my stomach is empty. Then both must be taken care of before I can tell it to you." "Ah, come in, come in." And so the publican gave him a great bowl of stew and a fine pint of something cold. And the peddler, he ate and he drank and he told the publican about his dreams. "Aye," says the publican, "aren't the dreams the strangest thing? I've been having this dream for the last 3 days about a treasure." "A treasure?" says the peddler. "Aye, a treasure," said the publican. "And it's buried under a great oak tree outside of some godforsaken village by the name of Ballaghaderreen." The peddler returned to Ballaghaderreen. And he went out in the back of his simple cottage and dug out of the roots of the oak tree. And there he found a chest of treasure. And so it was that the peddler never again was poor. And no one in his village or the villages nearby ever went without anything. And so it was that from that day forward, the peddler always listened to his dreams.